Good morning, students. Today here I am going to teach you the topic, the tundra region, and this topic is related to SST subject and it is lesson 10. This is my lecture 1. So students, today we will read about the tundra region. Here the whole thing is related to this topic here in this chapter. So before studying, going to the chapter in details, we are going to see a few topics that we will cover in this chapter. So students, what are the topics in this chapter that we will study? The topics are location, its climatic condition, and about its vegetation and wildlife. These three topics we are going to study about it, okay? So now the first topic is that location. So here the tundra region, about the location of tundra region, where it is located, students? Can anyone tell? Yes, the tundra region, it is located on the poles of the earth, and it is also the region of ice. Why the region, the term region of ice is used? Because the place is situated in the poles of the earth. We all know in the polar region the ice is there, the snow water is present in the form of ice there. So students, take out page number 63 in your book. All of you have taken out page number 63. Now see, in page number 63, in your chapter it is written there about the location. So see in your book, students, it is located on the poles of the earth. The tundra region, it is the region of ice. I have explained you earlier, it is the region of ice because it is situated in the polar regions. So the water present there, it is in the form of ice. This region is the subject of study and research for the whole world, as it is supposed to possess many hidden secrets of the earth. It is supposed to possess means, many hidden secrets of the earth are there. Many minerals, many things are found here. If we will continuously study there, we will do research work, we will find many things beneath the earth. So it is written here, this region is the subject of study and research for the whole world, and it possesses many hidden secrets of the earth. So now, about the location, we have already studied. The next topic is about the climatic conditions. So here we go in page number 63 only. Climate. The tundra region is the frigid zone of the earth. The climatic condition is there. It is the tundra region. First of all, it where it lies? It lies in the frigid zone of the earth. Due to its extremely cold weather and high windy condition, this region lacks biodiversity, because since it is situated in the polar region, so due to the extremely cold weather there and high windy condition, this region lacks biodiversity, as we have seen elsewhere on earth. The regions between the Arctic Circle, that is 66.5 degrees, the region between the Arctic Circle, that is 66.5 degrees, between the Arctic Circle 66.5 degrees north, that is Arctic Circle. You can write there Arctic Circle. And the North Pole, that is 90 degrees north. 90 degrees north is North Pole. Students, you can see here North Pole, and the Antarctic Circle, 66.5 degrees south and Antarctic Circle. Antarctic Circle and the South Pole, that is 90 degrees south. 90 degrees south. South Pole. So students, you can see here. These all degrees and the poles there. South Pole, it is situated in the 90 degrees south. North Pole, 90 degrees north. Arctic Circle in 66.5 degrees north. And Antarctic Circle, 66.5 degrees south. So here, these are the two regions, two tundra regions of the earth. The regions are covered with ice throughout the year. This region has mainly two seasons, that is summer and winter. Winter in this region is long, harsh and dark. Long, harsh. Harsh means severe cold days and dark. During this season, these regions are completely dark. The freezing temperature averages around minus 28 degrees Celsius. The freezing temperatures are here. See, what is the freezing temperature here? Minus 28 degrees Celsius. But sometimes can go low as minus 50 degrees Celsius. Okay. Now turn the page, students. Page number 64. Summer is very short and also not very warm in the tundra region. The tundra regions receive very scanty rainfall. Scanty here means very less rainfall is received, very less rainfall. That is why they are called cold desert. So the tundra region is also known as the cold desert. Now we will come to the next topic here, is about plant life. What is the next topic here, students? Yes, it is about plant life. The word tundra means treeless mountain tracts, suggesting that these regions do not have much vegetation. The soil in this region is mostly covered with permanently frozen soil called permafrost. What is the name of the soil present there? Permafrost, because it is mostly frozen there. Hence, growth of vegetation is not probable round the year. During summer, while the permafrost melts, some moss, lichen and crowberry and blackberry can grow in these regions. The only tree found in the tundra is called the dwarf willow tree. Okay students, you have understood this. Now we will come to the next type of life here, is about animal life. The next type of life we are going to study is about animal life. In the extremely cold climate in this region, it is nearly impossible for any life to survive in its natural form. Only few animals like reindeer, polar bears, etc., which have adapted themselves completely to the environment of the tundra regions. Adapted here means, what is the meaning of adapted? Adapted here means they have adjusted themselves. Adapted here means they have adjusted themselves to the surroundings so that they can survive there. The polar bears, for example, have thick layer of fat under their skin that saves from them from the severe cold. They have adapted to cold so well that now they can get overheated on heavy physical activity. They feed primarily on seals. Their main food is seals there. Their wet feet helps them in swimming in the sea for longer durations at a stretch. Means for a longer time they can swim in the sea there. Other animals too in these regions are adapted to the conditions and have thick coat of fur to guard against the biting cold. So they can protect themselves from the severe colds there. Now we will come to the last topic of this chapter, that is about human life. The last topic of the chapter, the tundra region. Like plants and animals, the story of human survival in the tundra region is also commendable. Commendable means, you can see here, commendable means that people think is good. Or in simple terms, you can write here, commendable means praiseable. Whom we can praise, praiseable. The total human population of the whole tundra region would not be more than 1 lakh, comprising mainly the Eskimos of North America, the Lapps of Scandinavia, the Samoyeds of Siberia, and the Yakuts of the Lena Basin, and the Koryaks and the Chukis of the former USSR. These all are the names of the tribes of different regions, different countries. Now, they lead to nomadic life, hunting for food, and live in igloos. What is the igloos here? Igloos, it is a house made of snow. They have lived a very simple life in this simplistic environment. However, with the advent of modern technology and communication mediums, things have changed for the inhabitants of the tundra region. Hunting of polar bears, fishing of seals and walruses, earlier done for the fulfillment of hunger, have now taken the shape of an industry. So now, students, I hope you have understood the chapter properly. So you read the chapter at home, and I think you have liked my class, so thank you.